The easiest way to get started with Kubernetes is to use the kubectl run command. Let's use the kubectl run command to launch a single instance of the Nginx container. As you can see, Kubernetes has created what is called a deployment. We'll explain more about deployments later, but for now, all you need to know is that deployments keep our pods up and running even when the nodes they run on fail. In Kubernetes, all containers run in what's called a pod. Use the kubectl get pods command to view the running Nginx container. Now that the Nginx container is running, we can expose it outside of Kubernetes using the kubectl expose command. So what just happened? Behind the scenes, Kubernetes created an external load balancer with a public IP address attached to it. Any client who hits that public IP address will be routed to the pods behind the service. In this case, that would be the Nginx pod. So if we list our services now, we'll see that we have a public IP that we can use to hit the Nginx container remotely. And there you go. Kubernetes supports an easy-to-use workflow out of the box using the kubectl run and expose commands. Now that you've seen a quick tour of Kubernetes, it's time to dive into each of the components and abstractions.